لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. We begin with the praise that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his beloved family members, upon his beloved companions and upon all of us and our family members. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless me in my speech, to remove the defects of my tongue, to make my task easy for me and bless me and grace me even more out of His grace and mercy so that all of you can understand my speech. Alhamdulillah. I welcome all of you to this series, inshallah ta'ala, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us understand. And inshallah, this series that I've intended to start is not a series that we only listen and know about the signs, but also inshallah ta'ala try to connect our lives and try to be better Muslims as the end is only coming closer. All right, so it's very, very important that you and I understand the importance of such a series and inshallah ta'ala connect our lives back to it. With this, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran in many, many ayats, but just to summarize them in a nutshell, Allah mentions when the sun is wrapped up, when the skies split open, when the seas erupt, when the mountains pass as if to say they are cotton and or wool. Brothers and sisters, all these ayahs that we read about a day of fear, a day that you and I would stand with nothing, absolutely nothing before us except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it only brings us fright, it only scares us, it only brings us fear in our heart, in our mind. And for many it would seem impossible that how is it possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would raise us from dust, would put our skeletons and bones and faces and eyes and legs and feet together, subhanAllah. For many it's an impossible task, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala it's easy. And the most important, I would say, sign is our own creation. When you look at yourselves, the beauty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. Allah says in the Quran in Surah At-Tin, Surah number 95 and Ayah number 4, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. How beautifully Allah says that I have created you, subhanAllah. Millions and millions and millions of years have passed by. And look at technology, how much it's grown, yet they can only be 1/10 of what the power of brain can do, subhanAllah. That is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But yet, when you and I as Muslims look at ourselves, look at our state of affairs, look at our surroundings, we fail to realize that this day even exists in our life. We are so overwhelmed by things around us, we have forgotten that there would be a day that I would stand before Allah. And this is nothing but heedlessness. Allah says in Surah Infitar, Ya ayyuhan nas, ya o mankind, ma gharrak. What's making you heedless? Bi rabbikal kareem, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's making you heedless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And brothers and sisters, sometimes you and I see people last Ramadan and this year, probably they aren't with us. Not that they've migrated to some other place, not that they've left their homes and gone to some other place. but they've left this dunya and gone to a different world. How many of you and I have witnessed death? Subhanallah. Brothers, I would ask you and I ask myself, how many times we've gone to a Salatul Janazah? How many times we've stood before a grave that is dug 6 feet and we stand there and know for a fact that you and I will be in it? Yet when we walk back as if to say we've left this the Akhirah way behind. We walk back to a dunya that is inviting us. And that's when we forget death. Brothers and sisters, death is the greatest reality of the end. Yes, death is the greatest reality of an end that is approaching. And as scholars say, that death is only the beginning of a new life. Death is the beginning of a new life. A life that you and I will be accounted for. A life that you and I have to stand before Allah. A life that you and I will be judged and rewarded or punished. Allahu Akbar. Imagine you stand and you are judged for your deeds. Yes, that day is known as Yawmul Hisab. That day is known as Yawmul Qiyamah, the day of standing. That day is known as the Yawmuddin, the day of judgment. Ever wondered what's going to happen to you and to me when we stand before Allah? Ever wondered when our life will be pulled up in front of our eyes, and from the day we matured, from till the day we died, our DVDs are being played and you are watching and saying, Ya Allah, you've not skipped anything, subhanAllah. Ya Allah, nothing has been missed out. Right? What happens to us on that day? The day before Allah that we stand, the day when Allah questions and we don't have a choice except that we answer. Today, you and I have a choice. And that choice is called as life. By Allah, as long as you and I are living, we have a choice to choose what is right. The moment we come to an end, subhanAllah, our deeds would speak. Our deeds will be presented. And by Allah, we have no choice except what Allah decides for us. Today, this dunya is so, it's so beautiful. I would always like to give an analogy like a sheikh gave once. I want all of you, we've seen enough pictures, we've seen enough movies to imagine some stuff, all right? We've done that past filth in our lives. So let's just assume. Imagine you're a hunter. You're a hunter in the deepest part of the jungle and you are hunting a wild beast ready with everything. Boom, what happens is there's a lion, a ferocious lion who jumps right at you. You don't know what to do. You just leave everything and you run. You run and you know that lion is chasing you. Now, I want you to picture this. You're running in the midst of the jungle. You're jumping off stones. There's a stream. You're running on the water. You're almost about to fall. And you know for a fact that you fall, you're dead meat. You're his lunch. Right? You're his lunch. Imagine at that time you're putting all your effort. You now want to just run away. And you see a small edge of a well. And you know the only way to save yourself is to jump into that water. Lo and behold, you come at that point and you jump in to see there's no water. Oops. There's a big snake, big serpent, opening its mouth, waiting to gulp you down. Death was right behind. Death is where you're gonna go. You now what you do, you have time. You're trying to touch the wall, you're trying to hold something. You find a small kind of a rope like a twine hanging there and you hold it. You hold it. And just when you hold it, you take the sigh of relief. Your breathing comes back. And now you see two mice, a black and a white. Mice nibbling down that rope. Almost coming to your thumb, almost coming to your finger. Just in all this confusion, you see honey dripping from a small edge. You see honey dripping from a small edge, from a honey beehive. And you put your finger and you lick it. And you say, SubhanAllah, that's sweet. You put your finger and you lick it again. You say, wow, that's sweet. And now you taste it and taste it. It's sweeter and sweeter and sweeter. And now you want more and more and more. Brothers and sisters, what just happened? In all this confusion of a lion chasing you, of a serpent waiting to gulp you down, in the midst of you being in the deepest part of the jungle, in the bottom of a well, you've just tasted honey and you said to yourself, it was sweet. And now you realize that the mice have just begun to eat your hands. What is this story about? The lion that was chasing you was death. The snake that's waiting for you is your grave. And the two mice, the black and the white, is the day and the night that just goes on and nibbling your life. You just go back. I was 20, I was young. Today I'm 40 and I was like, wow, 20 years just passed like this. Right? You just don't realize. You will be 60 and then suddenly somebody will be paying for your bills in the hospital. Right? Subhanallah. And you'll sit back and say, what have I done to my life? You know what that honey was? Honey was this dunya. Honey was this dunya. Sweet. I told my son this story and I asked him, what did you understand? He says, never to take honey in your life. Subhanallah. He at least got some part of the story. Right? This dunya is sweet. This dunya is too tempting. This dunya is beautiful. This dunya makes you forget reality. That's the problem. That's what it is. It's so beautifully set for us that Allah says, Zuyyina linnas. Allah has beautified it like a new bride. New bride, zinat, means to decorate a bride. Allah has beautified this dunya as a bride. Right? Just waiting. That's exactly what this dunya is. But it all will come to an end. It all will come to an end. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that end will have a new beginning. And that is the day of judgment. But then, will this day not have signs? Will this day not show its rays, its light? Yes, it will. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it does show its signs. It will show some of the minor signs. It will show major signs. It will show signs that you might yourself be a sign for the day of judgment. Subhanallah. There will be hadith that you and I will pull up in the series and say, Ya Allah, that's for me. I do that. Right? That's how much, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the signs before our eyes. And all these questions, what are its signs? What do I do? How do I prepare? What should I do? All these signs are only for a person who's bothered about his akhirah. The one who's negligent, the one who's heedless, doesn't even have to know its signs. Brother, the Dajjal's come out. The Dajjal's come out. No problem, I have my mother-in-law anyways. Subhanallah. If you have this in your life, you have nothing to fear, then there's absolutely nothing to even know about these signs. But if you really want to prepare yourself, then these are the signs that you and I today are witnessing. By Allah, they're witnessing. When you and I pull up ayats, when you and I pull up hadith, you're like, wow, subhanAllah, your hair will stand and say, Ya Allah, how close are we today? Is it the end of our existence or is it the end of the world? Subhanallah. Yes, brothers and sisters, today, inshallah, this series, let us revive myself first and then all of you. Let us revive our iman through this series. Let us revive our Islam through this series. Let us revive our ibadat through this series. Let us go back and prepare ourselves for this series that you and I, we have to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before the end of life, before the end of world, and before the end of days. With this, inshallah ta'ala, I would like to introduce the topic of this series, known as End of Days, the minor and the major signs of the Day of Judgment, inshallah ta'ala. This, inshallah, will be about an 8 to 9, roughly about 10 classes series. So I would love you to spend your Sunday afternoon here, inshallah, read Dhuhr and then go back and spend your day reflecting, talk to your families and inshallah getting some knowledge. So this is an intensive course. I've divided my course into 4 categories. A little bit on this dunya, because we need to, when you talk about, nobody starts the end of the movie, right? Everybody watches the beginning and what happens. So let's start a little bit of the beginning and then we come to the end. It's minor signs is part 2. It's major signs is part 3. And then what I've done is exclusively, I'm going to talk about the day of judgment and the whole course until you and I reach Jannah away from Jahannam. Inshallah, say Ameen. So, inshallah, it's about 8 to 10 classes as we progress. And inshallah ta'ala, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, surely you and I can take heed and you and I can change and be a part of reviving our iman. Inshallah, ameen, Allahumma ameen. With this inshallah, like I mentioned, let's go a little bit in the beginning. But before we start, here's a beautiful dua of the Prophet alayhi salam. Today, like my sheikh always says, that people in terms of knowledge are like Pepsi bottles. I said, sheikh, why Pepsi bottle? Have you seen a bottle fizzing up? The fizz is only in the beginning. MashaAllah, Zaid Bhai is taking a class, the whole class, the hall is full. Zabi Yusuf, get chairs. Next Sunday, boom, nobody's there, right? So let the fizz remain, So with this, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says a beautiful hadith. He says, سَيَأْتِيكُمْ أَقْوَامٌ. People will come to you. Yet يَطْلُبُونَ الْعِلْمِ. So that you learn, they learn ilm from you. Ilm. طَالِبُ الْعِلْمِ. طُلَّاب means student. فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُهُمْ. And when you see them, فَقُولُ لَهُمْ. فَقُولُ. So say to them, مَرْحَبًا بِوَسِيَّةِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Say to them, welcome. Say to them, congratulations. And say to them that you have taken the wasiyah, the testimony from the Prophet alayhi salam, subhanAllah. Why? Because Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the prophets don't leave dinars and dirhams, but they leave knowledge. And whoever takes a part of that knowledge, surely he has taken a lot, subhanAllah. He has taken a lot from that. And just before we get into our series, I would also try to reflect on one beautiful hadith. Today you've taken the step out of your homes. See what Allah will do to you, inshallah ta'ala. Look at this beautiful hadith. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever leaves his home, whoever travels today, whatever distance is, 1 kilometer or 10 kilometers, whoever travels in search of knowledge today, it's just not information about the day of judgment. It's just not information. It's about how, what a better Muslim can I be? If you go back with that, you've come into this path. What does Allah say? Whoever takes a path in terms of knowledge, يَطْلُوبُ الْفِيهِ عِلْمِ سَلَقَ اللَّهُ سَلَقَ اللَّهُ. Allah will make his path. Allah will make his path. Where? طَرِيق مِنْ طَرِيق مِنْ طُرُقِ الْجَنَّةِ مِنْ طَرِيقِ الْجَنَّةِ. From the path of Jannah, subhanAllah. What does this mean? When you start studying deen, when you start studying knowledge, when you start gaining knowledge, that fajr, which was difficult on you, becomes easy on you now. That isha that was really tough on you and your family becomes easy. Why? Because Allah has made it easy. Look what Allah says. Allah will make easy for him the path of Jannah. Is Fajr the path of Jannah or Jahannam? Jannah. So now the Fajr that was tough becomes easy or no? Subhanallah. So the moment you come and start studying, the things that were difficult on you becomes easy. Whose will? Subhanallah. Allah just chose you for that. Right? Allah just chose you for that. And my sheikh always tells me something amazing, amazing. When you study ilm, when you are in a path of Allah, you don't choose that. Allah chooses you for that. Allah chooses you for that. And that's something really important. Don't miss it, inshallah. Whatever little, you're still a part of this knowledge. You don't have to be ulama. Still a part of this knowledge and still a part of life becoming easy. And today, inshallah, we know some ayats about how and when and inshallah how things become difficult or easy, inshallah ta'ala. So another great thing before we move on to the last slide, inshallah, is knowledge in terms of ibadat. Wajib, fard is great. You can't compromise on that. If you come after fard, whether it's salah, nawafil, whether it's sawm, fasting, whether it's giving money, charity, whether it's knowledge, what is the greatest thing on earth? Allah's Messenger says something amazing. He says, Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, he says, Ya Abu Dharr, it is better for you to come out in the morning, whatever time you leave, to morning and learn one ayat, guys. Allah says one ayat. Allah's Messenger says one ayat. Better than what? 100 salahs, rak'ats. Subhanallah. Guys, pause. Let's take Taraweeh. 8 and 20, right? I'm not here to fight. 8, 100 rakats. How many days would you finish it? 12, 96. 12 days of Taraweeh was better than, one ayat was better than 12 days of Taraweeh. If you take 20, the amount is the same. Still 5 days. One ayat, guys. One ayat is better than 100 salahs. Now see what this is.
Allah's Messenger says, and for the one who comes out to learn a matter of this deen, subhanAllah. What are we studying? An ayat or the matter of this deen? A matter of this deen, of knowledge. Whether acted upon or not. Right? The signs of the day of judgment. Can you act upon the signs of the day of judgment? No, you can't. You hear about Ya'juj, Ma'juj, you hear about Dajjal. You can't become one. Even though we are one, similar to them today. Right? We can't become. It is better than praying 1,000 rak'ats. SubhanAllah. Calculate now, guys. That's ilm. That's knowledge. When we have it, we know it. We value it. When we don't have it, we don't even know what it means to us. So inshallah, with this, I come to the series called End of Days. Let's relive the sayings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And like I mentioned to you, this is a series of about 8 to 10 parts, inshallah, as much as we can. So with this, we come to part number one, at the very beginning of the creation. Right? Instead of getting to the end, let's go back and see how it all started. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, in many, many places about Adam alayhi salam. I'm sure we know this story, but I'm getting a point here, all right? The reason I got this ayat is I'm trying to get a point here. What does Allah say? Allah says, وَلَقَدْ and verily, we gave you authority. O man, we gave you authority on this earth and appointed for you therein provisions. So Allah says, we gave you earth and we've given you provisions after provisions. SubhanAllah. Guys, I'm sure all of us are in businesses and in jobs and so on. Think 2 minutes, take it off after the class. Name one source of income that is without using Allah's natural resources. Boom, take your time, wait for Dajjal to come, you won't say it. You need Allah's resources. So Allah says, I have given you provisions. That means you and I are only living on Allah's mercy. Yes or no? Absolutely. What Allah has given, I'm using it. And how? Have I thanked Him? No, I haven't thanked Him. Have I shown gratitude? No, I haven't shown gratitude. Right? I'm selfish, not selfless. That's the problem between the Sahabas and us. The Sahabas were selfless. We are selfish today. I just want me. Somebody told me, what's the full form of MBBS? Doctors around, don't get offended. What's the full form of MBBS? Mere biwi bache salamat. Right? SubhanAllah. It's just me today, right? It's just me, that's it. Nothing about my community today. We've woken up today because something's affected. Or else what happened to us? We were lazy guys. Never woken up, lynched. People were lynched, nothing happened. People were burnt alive, nothing happened. Today when it's come on us, mashallah, we are woken up as lions. So somewhere we are not thanking. So Allah says, little thanks you give. Allah is reminding us, man, everything is ours. Everything Allah has given us. Yet we thank Him really little. So then what happened? Allah talks about the creation of Adam alayhi salam. And then surely Allah says, we created your father Adam and gave him shape. So Allah says, Sawwarakum. Allah gave him surat. Allah gave him shape. The beauty we have today, subhanAllah. It's the most beautiful form that Allah has given us is humans. Right? Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. So Allah says, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ سَوَّرْ. So we created you and then we shaped you, fashioned you. And then what happened? وَقُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ. And we told the angels, what? Usjud, prostrate. Usjudu, prostrate to Adam. Not for ibadah, but for izzah. Not for ibadah, but for the rank that you and I as humans have before the creation. Right? We are knowledgeable people. Allah gave Adam knowledge the first thing that He created. So Allah gave him, so, li Adam. So everyone prostrated. Fasajadu, everyone prostrated. Except who? Iblis. Now comes the enemy of this entire creation. Right? Who stood up, revolted, rejected, refused Allah's commandment. It says, illa Iblis. He did not prostrate. Now, why? He says, Allah said, what stopped you, Ya Iblis? What stopped you? Ya Allah, I'm better, Ya Allah. I'm better. The first thing that Iblis did was arrogance. I'm better than you. Right? I'm better than you. That's the problem. So, when you commanded me, I'm better than him. So you created me from fire and him from clay. So that was the whole conversation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then He mentions about what? So Allah says, get down. Go out from this paradise. Get out. Right? It's not for people of arrogance. Out. Out you go, Iblis. It's not for people of arrogance. You want to be humble? Be in Jannah. You want to be obedient? Be in Jannah. So Iblis was humiliated. Now I'm coming to the point that I got this ayat. Now imagine, just I picture this. I'm not telling that you and I are Iblis, but I want you to picture this. Imagine if you were thrown out of Jannah, right? What's the first thing you would ask Allah? Come on, first thing. Forgiveness, that's what Adam did, mashallah, that's what our father did. But Iblis spoke about something that he had iman on. Boom. He says, Ya Allah, give me time until the day of judgment. Subhanallah. Iblis is walking out of Jannah and he reminds himself and the creation that there's a day that you and I will be accounted for. How arrogant can you get? Knowing the fact that there's a day of judgment, knowing the fact that you and I will be accounted for, and knowing the fact that I want to disobey on purpose. Now, pause. Put these three things, all right, of Iblis. Knowing the fact that the day of judgment exists. Knowing the fact that you will be accounted for the day of judgment. Right? Knowing the fact. And knowing that you have to obey. Put our life in these three. Subhanallah. Don't raise your hands. Don't feel embarrassed. Just say, ask yourself, have I as a Muslim actually turned like Iblis? I know the day of judgment is there. Yes or no, as Muslims? Yes. We know we are going to be accounted. Yes or no? Yes. We know we have to obey Allah. Yes or no? Yes. Then why is our life full of sins today? Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Isn't that something to worry and think over? Have we as a nation actually become like Iblis when he left Jannah there? Today, what's the biggest goal in your life? Sisters, brothers, what's the biggest goal of your life? What's your aim in our life if I tell you? To enter Jannah, yes or no? That's the biggest. What's your aim, brother? I want Jannah. Everybody wants Jannah. When Shaitan, Iblis was thrown out, he talks about these three things. Today we are living as these three things and we expect to get Jannah. Subhanallah. Isn't it really in a bad situation? Yes, it is. That's why Iman is a part. Day of Judgment is a part of our Iman. It's so important that you believe in the Day of Judgment. What is Al-Birr? Allah says, what is Al-Birr? Al-Birr is not that you face your heads towards Maghrib and Mashriq, East or West or no. Al-Birr is what? First of all, He says to believe in Allah, to have Iman in Allah. Second, the last day. The last day came before the angels. The last day came before the book. The last day came before the prophets. The last day came before he gives wealth. The last day came before he takes care of his parents. The last day came before orphans. The last day came before miskin. The last day came before salah. The last day came before zakat. The last day came before fulfilling a promise. The last day came before sabr. Everything. Subhanallah. Where did Allah place iman on the akhirah? After him. Subhanallah. Allah didn't say, believe in Allah, pray salah, give zakat, take care of your parents, take care of orphans, have sabr, go for battle, what? And then have akhirah. No, Allah says, amantu, to believe in Allah, wa bil yawm al-akhir. So iman on the day of judgment came after Allah. That's the level of iman that you and I have to have, subhanAllah. Now ask yourself a question, where is this in our life? What's the priority? Allah has prioritized number two. Guys, number two, in this ayat of Birr, I pulled this up from the Quran. Surah Al-Baqarah, surah number 2, ayah 177, if you want to take the note. 177, ayah number. I pulled it up from the Quran. If Allah has prioritized it in number two in our life, where have you and I put this in our life? Subhanallah. So now, we come. When Adam alayhi salam was thrown out, or rather removed from Jannah, He got this dunya. So let's understand the value of this dunya. The world is more insignificant in the eye of Allah as a dead lamb. It's a beautiful hadith. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was walking in the market once. Now, if you know the price of animals back then, today you would say a price of cars, right? Today it's the cars, branded cars, the best of cars. Back then it was about animals, horses, camels, and mules, and so on. So even, you know, wealth was in terms of sheep and goats you had and so on. So Allah's Messenger was walking in the marketplace and he saw a dead carcass, dead, short ears, you know. So he sat down close to the carcass and he told his sahabas, how much would any one of you buy this carcass for? The sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, who would pay for this? Allah's Messenger would say, come on, 1 dirham, 2 dirhams, how much? They said, Ya Rasulullah, we won't even take it if it's free. First of all, we as Muslims can't eat a dead animal. It's not been sacrificed in the way of Allah, right? In the right way. Second, it's dead. I cannot use it for milk or wool or whatever. It's dead. It's gone. So everything for me, it's a waste. So even if somebody gives it to me free, I won't take it. Allah's Messenger smiled and looked at the sahabas and said, if this animal is worthless before you, the dunya is worthless before Allah. Just like the dead carcass. So today, we are actually falling in love with the dead carcass. That's exactly what's happening. And Allah's Messenger said a beautiful hadith that the world is a prison. It's a sijin for a believer. So if you're feeling the tightness today, pat your back and say, MashaAllah, Allah has actually made me a believer. If your life is amazing, luxury, having fun, enjoying life, today you don't have any effect of what's happening in the Muslim world or in you individually, then subhanAllah, think again, where are you? And reflect on your iman. Because Allah's Messenger says that this life is a prison for the believer. What's a prison? He's always jailed in. He just can't break through. Struggles, hardships, life. Life is like that. While the same world is Jannah for a disbeliever. These are Allah's Messenger's words. So when Allah's Messenger was sitting one day, and he came to, he was sitting with his companions, Jibreel alayhi salam came. And Jibreel alayhi salam sat with his knees touching the knees of the Prophet salam like this. Like, you know how you sit, right? Respectfully, when you're studying or reading the Quran. You're sitting and all the men around them were surprised because they had never seen this man before. It's a long hadith, I'll cut short it. He asked about Iman, he asked about Islam, he asked about, you know, about Ihsan. And then towards the end, he said, Ya Rasulullah, tell me about the signs, the day of judgment. The Prophet ﷺ replied that the one who asked the question is like the one who's asking. I don't know the answer. You and me, you're asking me, I don't know. So to Jibreel, nobody knows it's Jibreel alayhi salam. The man said, okay, tell me its signs. So Jibreel alayhi salam told, tell me its signs. So now here's the first hadith that we've got into our class, all right? I'm building it up for you. He says, tell me the signs. The first sign, he says, when the slave girl will give birth to her mistress, meaning to her master. Next, when you will see the barefoot, the naked and the dependent shepherds compete in construction of tall buildings. Subhanallah. All right, pause. Right? When you take a shepherd, what were Arabs way back? Where were Arabs way back before they got oil? Shepherds. What happened to them after oil? Gone to Dubai anytime? Tall buildings? First sign? Subhanallah. Right? Today when you see buildings built by Arab nations and competing 135 floors, all right, another king will come, I'll make 170, man. Right? You go on and on, tall buildings. The man returned and then they asked him, Ya Rasulullah, Umar said, we don't know who he is. Look what Allah's Messenger says. Allah's Messenger says, this is Jibreel. Verily, he was Jibreel who came to teach your religion. What do we get from this hadith? Who came to teach your deen, your religion? studying the signs of the Day of Judgment is what? A part of your deen, iman. So when you know them, you actually reflect upon them, subhanAllah. So, what's the true success? When you are going to face death, this is the most frightening ayat. Allah says, كُلُّ نَفْثٍ ذَائِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Allahu Akbar. Just the verse itself is frightening. Every soul shall taste death. And look at the word ذَائِكَ. ذَائِكَ means to taste the flavor. I'm sure all the women who cook really well, mashallah, Muslim women by nature cook well, right? Mashallah, amazing. Some of my non-Muslim friends, when they say biryani, they make palau there. We make biryani, right? So what's the ذَائِكَ? ذَائِكَ is to the flavor, subhanAllah, the favor, flavor. Allah says that every nafs, every soul will taste the flavor of death. Allahu Akbar. And then, وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفُّونَ أُرُوجُ. And then you will be paid your wages on the Day of Judgment. And then Allah's Messenger says, فَقَدْ زُحْزِهَا عَنِ النَّارِ. Whoever saved from the fire, وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ. And who is made to enter Jannah, فَقَدْ فَازَ. This is success. Success is not how many buildings you make. Success is not how many cars I drive. Success is not how much of money that I accumulate. Success is if you can jump over that bridge and get across Jannah. That's success. That's it. A journey will come when you just have to cross Jahannam. You fall into it, that's gone. Allahumma musta'an. Right? May Allah save us from that. Ameen. So, then look at the last part of this ayat. What does Allah say? وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاءُ الْغُرُورِ. And know that the life is only enjoying and a deception. It's just enjoying and deception. Nothing but just deceives. So how did we get here? How did we get to this dunya? So going back, Adam alayhi salam made a mistake with his wife, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are punished, you need to leave Jannah. Adam alayhi salam accepted, he asked for repentance, and Allah forgave him. So Iblis was not forgiven, Adam alayhi salam was forgiven, but he was made to live in a test. This is a test, right? So then he was made to send this dunya. So Allah says, get down from paradise. All of you, get down. Both of you, that means husband and wife, together, some of you will become enemies to others. Aren't we seeing that today? SubhanAllah. Forget non-Muslims, guys. Muslims today are, within ourselves, we have more jealousy and hatred than love and peace. Then what does Allah say? Then, minni, from Allah, hudan faman tabi'a hudaya, fala yudilla wala shikwa, wala yashka. And from there, my guidance will come to you. And whoever takes my guidance, every time from time to time, will neither go astray nor will fall into distress. Look at the word yashqa, yashqa. What is the word shik, shikwa? What's shikwa? Grief, complain, stress. I'm always complaining. Brothers, sisters, how's your health? No, my, always been, always. Just we've forgotten to be happy, right? Look at America, they're selling more antidepressants than any other tablet in the globe. Why is everybody turning depressed today? Everybody's turning depressed because we've turned our backs to the Quran. We don't know the real happiness. So Allah says, misery, misery. Now look at the next ayat, even more dangerous. Allahu Akbar. May Allah save us from this. Look at the next ayat, the importance of following guidance. The next ayat, 124. What does Allah say? So whoever turns away from my reminder, whoever turns away from my reminder, all right? We will make his life hard. We will make his life full of hardship. SubhanAllah. Pause. Before I even go to the next ayat or next part, today as a nation, open the globe, pick a country and tell me, are we happy or are we in hardship? Hardship. Right? We're struggling everywhere. Open the globe, there's blood, there's Muslim. Open the globe, there's violence, there's Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran clearly that whatever bad happens to you, it is from your own self, and min anfusikum, from your own selves. So you and I can't complain today to anybody else that because of them or because of them. No, it's because of our own sins. It's what we have occurred, what we have done, what we have earned, right? And then Allah says, we shall raise you blind. Again, He connects it back to the Day of Judgment. Blind to the Day of Judgment. The next ayat says, I haven't put that, but the next ayat says, Ya Allah, why am I blind when I could see on the day of in my this life? Allah says, you turn away from my ayat, today I turn away from you. Allahu Akbar. You don't even get the joy of looking at Allah that you and I worship all our life. If you and I have to turn away from Allah or His ayats. Subhanallah. Now I come to a beautiful passage. How many of you know Jibreel alayhi salam? We all know him, right? Mashallah. We all have iman on him. We love him, right? He's one of our, you know, subhanAllah, the most beloved angels. Do you think Jibreel alayhi salam was scared of anything? He was the mightiest angel, right? Allah chose him to be his angel that would go and deliver messages. I would say Jibreel was scared once. When was Jibreel scared? Subhanallah. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting in his house and Jibreel comes down in his house and he's talking to Jibreel and he's talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Messenger, and while having a conversation, the heaven cracks. It's a sahih hadith, alright? A heaven cracks and Jibreel alayhi salam looks up and Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, by Allah, I saw Jibreel scared. I saw the fear on Jibreel's face. And then Jibreel alayhi salam looks up and there's an angel who comes down to greet Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Jibreel says, Ya Rasulullah, this is Israfil. Meet him today. Pause. Who's Israfil? Who's Israfil? The one who will blow the trumpet for the day of judgment. When Israfil will blow the trumpet, lo and behold, everything will perish. Imagine Jibreel alayhi salam. So I want you to think of this moment. Jibreel, the mightiest angel, he's sitting with the greatest of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They're having a conversation, and I'll tell you that conversation, subhanAllah. They're having a conversation, the heaven splits. And Israfil, who's never come down, he comes down. And Jibreel says, Ya Rasulullah, this is Israfil. Allah's Messenger, after Israfil goes, he says, Ya Jibreel, I saw the fear on your face. He says, Ya Allah, Ya Rasulullah, I swear by Allah, I thought it was the day of judgment today. Allahu Akbar. Imagine Jibreel alayhi salam himself being frightened of the day of judgment. What would happen to us when we see it? The likes of Muhammad is sallallahu alaihi wasallam are scared. The likes of Jibreel was scared. The likes of Israfil will be scared. What about you and me then? Subhanallah. And you know what advice he gave? Subhanallah. Look at this advice. Amazing, brilliant. This is Jibreel's advice to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'll first read the Arabic and then we'll go to the English inshallah. Look at the Arabic first. Jibreel alaihi told Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, Ya Rasulullah, he says, Ya Muhammad, ish ma shi't. Live as you wish. فَإِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ. And know that you will die. He's giving an advice. Allah's Messenger is getting an advice from Jibreel. Live as you wish, but know that you will die. And then he says, وَعْمَلْ مَا شِئْتْ. Work, do any deed. But know that you will be accounted before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَحَبِّبْ مِنْ شَيْتْ. Love whoever you want. فَإِنَّكَ مُفَارِقَتُ. And know that you will be separated from them. وَعْلَمْ. And know أَنَّ الشَّرْف. The izzah, the sharf means honor. The izzah, the honor, the dignity, the pride of whom? Of a mu'min is where? قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. Allahu Akbar. The pride of a believer is قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. And what does he say? وَعِزَّتُ. And the izzah is to stay away from people, being independent from people. Look at the English now. Sahal ibn Sa'az radiallahu anhu reported that Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet alayhi salam and advised him. He says, Ya Muhammad, live as you wish, Ya Rasulullah. Live, for you will die. Work as you wish, for you will be repaid accordingly. You will be repaid accordingly. Love whoever you want, and you will be separated. Know that the nobility, the izzah, the dignity of a believer is the prayer at night, and the honor of his is being independent of people. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, understand, This is what Allah's Messenger got advice from Jibreel alayhi salam. Now look what happens to Allah Prophet himself. The Prophet was sleeping once. He was sleeping and suddenly he woke up. And when he woke up, his beloved wife Aisha asked, Ya Rasulullah, what happened? You saw something bad? What happened? He says, by Allah, I was shown an image today. She said, what image, Ya Rasulullah? He says, I was shown a sign of the day of judgment. And Allah's Messenger is shivering, he's sweating, he's scared. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, what is that sign? He says, I saw a hole being made in the wall of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Today, how many years back? 1,400 plus years. Today a hole was made. Who's Ya'juj and Ma'juj? Who's Dajjal? Who's Imam Mahdi? Inshallah, we do all of that. But just the fact that Allah's Messenger was scared on the whole of Ya'juj, Ma'juj. What about they coming out? Allahu musta'an. Allahu Akbar. Can you even imagine what would happen to us and to you and to me when they come out? The Rasulullah was scared of a small hole in his time. What about people? What would happen when they come out? Allahu musta'an. So my dearest brothers and sisters, understand the first sign of the day of judgment is the coming of messengers. Whose ummah are we? Come on, whose ummah are we? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. A hadith says, collected by Musnad Imam Ahmad and is classified Sahih, that 1,24,000 prophets lived. Right? 1,24,000 prophets. So now, if I was in the 10th prophet's time, did I have to worry? Actually, no. Right? I don't have to worry because 1,23,000 are still left, right? Even if I was the 1,000th nation, 1,23,000 are still left. 1,24,000. Today, the first sign of the day of judgment is the life of Prophet Muhammad. Why? Because he is the last. Whether you like it or no, we are the last nation. We are the last nation to be raised, and we are the last nation to be raised dead, right? And we will be the first one to be accounted though. SubhanAllah. That is the izzah that this nation has got. But the death of the Prophet Islam, meaning there's no other ummah, there's absolutely no other ummah that is gonna come after us. No new ummah will be born after us. We are the last and we will be the last. But Allah's Messenger has given us signs after signs. And inshallah, I would like to end with one of the greatest signs that he said. Allah's Messenger said that I, that is Rasulullah, and the day of judgment have come like this. Allahu Akbar. That's scary now. I and the day of judgment have come like this. Meaning, it is just following. It is just things happening. Just happening. So inshallah ta'ala, in my next class, we will pull up some hadith from minor signs that have already occurred and are occurring, inshallah. And then we move to our major signs. Major signs are 10. Inshallah, I know we haven't seen them, but we've come so close. By Allah, we've come so close that you might think, whoa, it just could happen any time of our life. With this, inshallah ta'ala, every class I would leave you with some lessons so that you and I go back, just not to hear and go back, but also take it down, understand and change our lives. About 7-8 lessons from this today's class. Number one, Rasul makes dua for those who come out and learn. So that's really, really important. If you want pictures, please take it. Rasul makes dua for those who come out and learn. That's number one. Second, Iman on the day of judgment means it needs to be your priority. Where did Allah place it in the priority list, by the way? I forgot. SubhanAllah. Can we place that there? Right? That's number one. We need to place it at priority. The life of this dunya is an enjoyment and something that deceives. So that's very, very important that you and I should understand that honey was sweet, but sometimes it is dangerous, all right? Guidance brings blessings while misguidance brings hardships. We open that ayat of Surah Taha. Allah said, you take guidance, you'll never be in distress. Never be in distress. You leave my guidance, you'll have a life full of hardships. Full of hardships. Today, it might not be a community. Forget, take it individually. Financially, you might be get beaten up. Your problems in your spouse, with business, parents, children growing up, whatever it is, you are not, you're depressed, you're low, you have worry, you have problems, you have grief, you have sorrow. That's because of this. Take it up, inshallah Allah will bless. Number two, remember knowledge is a path of Jannah. Number three, later on, Jibreel's advice to Rasulullah on life, remember, do what you want, but you will be accounted for. Do deeds that you will be repaid for. Alright? So inshallah, and what is the izzah of a believer? Come on, what's the izzah of a believer? Qiyamul layl, the hajj. And then you and I will stand before Allah, and the true success is Jannah. So let's prepare it, for it, inshallah ta'ala. And may Allah make us from Jannah and Jannah al-Firdaus. Ameen Allahumma ameen. Inshallah ta'ala. Inshallah, as we move ahead, we will understand this entire series unfolding. And inshallah, may Allah give you blessings and inshallah understanding. And inshallah, make us together and understand this program, inshallah ta'ala. With this, I leave you with the dua of the Prophet ﷺ that he leaves with. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.